Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started.
Thank you.
Next, Roland Behm.
Madam Chair, members of the committee, I'm grateful for the opportunity to speak to you today. I come in here in strong support of HB 520. As you mentioned, my name is Roland Behm. I volunteer and serve as a board member with the Georgia chapter of the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. To clear up a misunderstanding, it is not a psychopharma organization. It's a volunteer organization that happens to provide the largest amount of private funding for suicide prevention research in the United States. So let's deal with the facts and move from there. I'm also the co-founder of the Georgia Mental Health Policy Partnership today. My remarks focus on three things. One, the studies and task forces under HB 520 are not an expansion of state government. Georgia is at the beginning of a journey to transform mental health and substance use care in the state. The studies and task forces will create the map for that journey. Absent a map, Georgia's journey will be aimless and costly, both in terms of individual health outcomes and taxpayer funds. The studies and task forces will provide transparency and accountability for the journey, and there is a need to ensure that behavioral health care in the state achieves the best results while ensuring that government is an effective steward of taxpayer funding. Second, data referenced in HB 520 are safeguarded by state and federal laws and regulations. Those safeguards are a function of the data itself and exist independent of the bill. Unless required to ensure the health and safety of an individual, no data can be used to personally identify Georgia citizens. The de-identified data currently exists and is being used by individual agencies. The bill enables the sharing of the de-identified data to create the behavioral health care map that we need. Third, HB 520 does not expand Medicaid in Georgia. As you heard from Chairman Jones, nothing in HB 520 results in an increase in the number of Medicaid enrollees, nor does it require any additional funding by Georgia for its Medicaid programs. The bill provides most effective treatment options for Medicaid enrollees. Thank you.
Okay, next, Mallory Staples.
Thank you.